guys I trained with all the time that had really good front heads, and they would choke you and they'd hurt your neck, pretty much. And I'd like to take a lot of shots, so I didn't want to get my neck hurt, so I'd shoot, and he'd be locked in a pretty good position here, and they'd be trying to choke me, trying to freestyle, trying to like under hips into me and jam my neck like this. So I learned to fight their hands where this bottom hand that's on my neck, I bend his wrist. So I get to that part by his knuckles, and I bend his hand this way, and I push the elbow together. So it kind of looks like this, right? And now I got him in an awkward position. It's hard for him to have a good lock on me. And then from here, I'm able to circle out of it. So if I shot down the mat, push front hand, I'm on this elbow, and then my elbow's back, I'm fighting this hand. Right, I'm fighting the fingers towards his forearm. Now he can't really let it, even if he's trying to relock you. Got a good position there. So, you know, I think that, you know, guys that have maybe you wrestle on the team, they go head in the hole and they're trying to create all the time. If your guys do take a bad shot, they got to be thinking elbow and break that wrist, right? That'll prevent that head in the hole, right? So, and I know from experience that really works. With some of these guys, if they got me good, they can choke me unconscious. But I get that elbow and that wrist like this, they don't have that choke bone. It's not locked into your throat. So, you know, the same thing with a head in the hole. You'll see a good high school kid. He goes head in the hole. He's kind of choking you a little bit, trying to get that cradle or whatever he's trying to do. So, elbow, fold the wrist. What else in there? That short offense. It seems like, you know, at every level, short offense is such a big thing, because whether it's your guys taking a bad shot or the other team taking a bad shot, it's something you're going to end up underneath there. One thing we've been doing lately for the offensive guy and the defensive guy, really, just so he learns how to like float his hips and use baseline defense, try to shoot a single on me. Right, and I let him in, good position, his head's good. And now, right away, I'm looking to locate his head, stuff it down, and then my wizard side, right, my wizard side is going to come from the wizard, and it goes right to his hip. All right, right to his hip. All right, now I'm going to slide off the shot, and I'm going to extend him and stretch him. All right, so I extend him, go to my laces, I slide, he goes to his post. All right, he's to his post. All right, I slide, I stuff his head, I go to his hamstring, stretch him a little bit. Turning my toes out, so I'm in good position. Right now, I'm gonna let him regather. He's regathered. As soon as he gets a good position on the single, I'm gonna throw his head to the outside. All right, I throw his head to the outside, stuff down. Again, my other hand to the belly, to the hip. Slide off the shot. Slide off the shot, stretch him, catch an angle on an ankle. It'd be heavy. All right, now he's gonna post and recover. Back to his high C. I throw his head again, stay located on it, hit him, slide off the shot, stuff, square. Look to chase the hamstring. He posts, he recovers, I throw. All right, so we do that slow.
Do that again.
Right, really slow. All right, because now it's almost like they're lifting weights. Right, because he's extended, he has to think about, I better unlock my hands. Right, if I don't unlock, I'm gonna get scored on. So he unlocks, he posts, he fires back in. He's like doing like a mini knee slide, right? Like a mini knee slide drill. So I'll do it with Brian this time. I hit, I'm in good position. He stuffs me down, I'm posting. He squares up, checks his position, toes out, hips into me, he's heavy. He's gonna let me gather. I gather, going ahead. Looking to score, good position, hips are down. See the U in his back? See how his back's kind of U'd? That's good pressure on my shoulder. It's hard for me to recover out of here. He lets me gather. Same thing, down with my head. Pull it. Right, that's a really good drill. I talked about your head first, then blocking with your hands, and then that third level is your hips. You know, learning not to pat. But he gets in so many times, guys, they turn down, try to do all the stupid stuff, you know? try to get your leg back. Pick up the chest. Be heavy on him. Right? This time, I'm kind of pushing his head down and away. Because if he attaches his head to my body,